Ableton Live comes with a set of tools to generate rhythms, patterns, and chords, all easily accessible in the clip view. Let's take a closer look. You can choose between the tools using this drop-down menu. Let's explore the rhythm generator and create a beat in a drum rack. I'm going to start by selecting the closed hi-hat pad using the menu, and suddenly some notes will appear in the note editor window. This is because the generate button is on by default, which means that any changes I make to the parameters in the generator will be automatically reflected in the clip. I can toggle this button off if I like. Now, any changes I make will only be printed by clicking the Apply button or using the shortcut Command Enter on a Mac or Control Enter on Windows. Let's select the bass drum and explore the parameters. This time, instead of using the menu, I'll hold down Option on a Mac or Alt on Windows and click on the note in the piano ruler. Steps sets the number of steps in a pattern, and density defines the number of notes within those steps. The pattern parameter cycles through a number of different patterns, and the higher your step setting is, the more possible patterns are available. Step duration defines the length of each possible step. Shift moves the pattern forwards or backwards in time. Below this, we can set the bass velocity for the generated notes, as well as the velocity of accented notes. We can use the Freak control to define the amount of accented notes in the pattern, and we can shift the resulting velocity pattern to the left or the right using the arrows. Finally, the split slider determines the chance that a step will be split into equal length notes. Let's move on to generating a melodic pattern. I'll double-click on an empty clip slot on this track, which houses an electric piano instrument, and then I'll select Seed from the drop-down menu. I'll start off by selecting a pitch range for my generated notes. As we can see and hear, Live has generated a pattern of notes that adhere to the scale I chose. I can also set a duration range and control how long or short the notes can be. And I can also set a velocity range. Clicking the Apply button or using the shortcut Command Enter on a Mac or Control Enter on Windows will keep regenerating patterns that fit my parameter choices. I'll regenerate a few until I'm happy with one. The Voices slider defines the maximum possible amount of voices. And the density slider determines the total amount of notes that will be generated. Now I'd like to add a counter melody to this idea. Double-clicking again in an empty clip slot, this time on a third track, creates a new MIDI clip. Here, I'll select the shape generator and move a parameter to automatically generate an upward ramp of notes. I'll use the minimum pitch and maximum pitch choosers to generate notes in a slightly lower register and start exploring the parameters from here. The rate knob sets the minimum length of the generated notes, and by default is set to match the current grid. The tie knob defines the likelihood of a note's length being extended to merge with the next note. And the density knob defines how many notes are generated within the chosen shape. Jitter adds a bit of random deviation to the shape of the pattern. You can explore a selection of patterns from the drop-down menu, or you can draw your own custom shapes. Stacks is a great way of exploring chords. In a new MIDI clip, I'll begin by dragging the chord symbol up and down to scroll through some shapes. The notes, chord names, and scale degrees are all listed in the bottom left of Live's interface. When I have a chord I like, I'll click on the plus button and add a new chord inside the currently selected space. I can continue to do so. I can also scroll through possible inversions of the currently selected chord, and also change the root note. I can change the length of the current selected chord using the duration chooser and offset the chord's start time. Finally, you can add custom generators in the form of Max for Live patches nested into the Generators tab. Here, for example, is a Euclidean generator with a range of options for generating rhythms based on subdivisions of whole numbers.